Let's see how to get started with PostgresQL and pgAdmin using Docker. This kind of setup can be very useful for learning, testing, and development tasks. Before we start, make sure that Docker is up and running in your computer. And if you have it installed and the Docker engine is running, we're good to go. So we're going to use two Docker images for this setup. And if we take a look at hub.docker.com, we can see both of these images here. So the first one, as we said, is Postgres. And here it is, the first option here. And in this page, you can see all of the documentation for the Postgres image. The second image we will use is pgAdmin4. And the specific one that we're going to use is the first one, dpage/pgAdmin4. So this is the image that we will use for pgAdmin itself. But we're not going to run each of the containers separately. We're going to use Docker Compose. Docker Compose is a tool that allows us to define and manage multi-container Docker applications. For our scenario, we'll have two containers, one for PostgresQL and another for pgAdmin. Because we'll define both of them in the same Docker Compose file, they will share the same network, allowing them to communicate with each other. So to get started with Docker Compose, we need to create a Docker Compose file. So I already created an empty folder here, and in this folder, I'll create the docker-compose.yml file. And let's start editing this file. So first, we need to specify the version of the YML file, and it's going to be version 3. Next, we need to specify the services, and as we said, we're going to have two of them, database and pgAdmin. For each of the services, we need to specify the image that it's going to use. Now, as we said, for the DB, we're going to use the Postgres image. And for the pgAdmin service, we're going to use the dpage pgAdmin4 image. We now need to specify the environment variables for each of the services. For Postgres, we need an environment variable called Postgres password. And here we need to specify the password for PostgresQL. For the pgAdmin service, we need two environment variables. These are the username and password to log into pgAdmin, and they are called pgAdmin default email and pgAdmin default password. Next, I want to specify a volume for the DB service. Using a volume will allow us to have persistent data in the container. That means that if, for any reason, we remove the container and then create a new container using the same Docker Compose file, all of the data for PostgresQL will be restored. So we won't have to start fresh and recreate all of our tables and data because we're going to save all of this data on the local computer, on the host. So we're going to give the container access to a folder on the host, and this way, this data will be persistent among containers. So first, let's create the folder on the host, and I'll call this folder Postgres data. And now we can create the volume using this folder. So first, we specify the folder on the host, and then colon, and then the folder inside the container. In the case of a PostgresQL container, it needs to be var lib PostgresQL data. The last thing we need to specify is port forwarding. PostgresQL uses port 5432, so we can forward this port from the host machine to the same port inside the PostgresQL container. Now, the UI for pgAdmin is basically a web server, so we need to expose port 80 in this service. Now, because I want port 80 to keep working normally in the host, I'm going to use some other port in the host to forward to port 80 inside the container. So a popular choice is port 8080. So we're going to forward port 8080 in the host to port 80 in the container. We also want the pgAdmin container to depend on the PostgresQL container, and the meaning is that the PostgresQL container will always start first. And I wrote here db because this is the name of the PostgresQL service. And just to be on the safe side, maybe I'll replace the backslashes with forward slashes in the volume definition. Okay, so we're done with writing our Docker Compose file, and now we can run it. So let's open the terminal in the folder that contains this file. And here I run Docker Compose app. This command will download the necessary Docker images, if not already present locally, and create and start the Docker containers. Okay, so the Docker services are up. Let's open the web browser and let's navigate to port 8080 at localhost. And we get to see the pgAdmin login screen. We defined the credentials in the Docker Compose file, so I'll copy them from there. And let's log in. So we're now logged into pgAdmin, and we can create a connection to the PostgresQL server itself. So here I'll right-click on Servers, and under Register, I'll choose Server. So let's type a name for this server. Then we can move over to the Connection tab. For the hostname, I'll type in DB, because this is the name that we used in Docker Compose for our PostgresQL service. Now the default username for PostgresQL in Docker is Postgres, so that's what I'll type in as the username. And as for the password, I'll just copy it from the Docker Compose file. Let's now click on Save. And we're now connected to the PostgresQL server, and we can see all of the data of this server.